I know I feel like it seems like I say this more or less every little content on my channel. Basically, the only reason for that is the fact that Battlefield 1 is now out, so that's been devouring all my playtime. And between recording for YouTube and actually just playing that, with the cost of the latter one quite a lot of the time.
Its noble end affords you broad tolerance in your choice of means.
So now I need to try and work out where we are now. Because it's been like a couple of weeks and I don't know what's happening. Yeah, that's nice, okay. If I remember rightly, we picked up a couple of people here. Okay. Our roster's nearly full. These new guys need naming, so a jester. Okay, well, the Houndmaster, I know who that's going. It's going to be Andy, or Monster Riffs, as he's known on PSN, and he pretty much has to be a Houndmaster because. Anybody who knows him in real life knows that he dotes on his dog more than like anything else, girlfriend included. So it's only fitting, really. So you can tell I haven't played it in a little while because I'm okay, yeah, we get that. No, stop it. Okay. That's trinkets. Don't care about trinkets. What am I trying to do here? Why can't I just move? Okay, there we go. Not sure what was going on there. 2-speed below, with torch below 26. Yeah, that's not going to be a problem. That's pretty good. We've got a grave robber and a man at arms. I've been waiting to pick one of these up. Do we not already have one? Or is this me other? No, we don't. It's me other me other playthrough that we've already got one. Right. Nocturnal. That's pretty bad. But, you know, Last Gasp isn't terrible either. Right. So who can you be? Actually, what I should do is check who I've already got. Don't want to, like, have two of someone. Right, okay, yeah. Who can you be? Right. You can be Gary. Because, even though this guy's grey, my friend Gary is an absolute mountain of a man, even if he is ginger. So there we go. Is there anyone else we need in here? Jesus Christ, I didn't realise just how many people we've picked up recently. Grave robber. Who would make a good grave robber? I have no idea. I think, yeah. I was going to say Richard, but we've already got Richard. I suppose it doesn't matter, really. You can be, man, I don't want to do that. You can be anybody. You can be, she'll kill me. You can be, my girlfriend. You can be Amy. Right, there we go. I'm probably going to get a slap for that, but you know. And if anything, right, it's not so much like in our relationship, I'm the cradle robber, never mind a grave robber, because she's several years younger than me, but never mind. Right, okay. Jester, who's the biggest fucking joker on my friends list? Good question. He's not a joker. He's a nice lad, actually. But I'm running out of names for people. Is that even how you spell it? No, it's not. It's like that. Pretty sure it's 88. I'm sure he'll correct me if I'm wrong. Scotty Too Hottie, you are now our newest jester. Right. So that's that done with. Okay. I'm actually going to unequip all of our trinkets, yeah. Still don't have that many, really. Let's see what we're doing mission-wise. So these should be the people who've literally just been on a mission, yeah. So we'll, oh yeah, because yeah, because Cooper got spasm of the entrails, didn't he? Which is like heart imitating life because he suffers from Crohn's. Right. So where are we going first of all? We could go at the Warrens, just because I don't think we've actually done the mission there yet. I suppose what I should do is look at what the 15% healing skills, that'll be like, well, regardless of what healer we put on, that's really good. Let's see what else is on offer. Caution cloak. Oh dear me. No, don't like that at all. Tenacity ring. That's actually really good, considering all you're losing is 1% crit. Stun amulet, also pretty decent. Could probably use that a great effect. But I think we should stick to our initial plan and go to the Warrens. Right. So then, this is an apprentice level 1. I think we'll stick to our sort of usual plan of taking out a couple of level 1s and a couple of newbies. Right, I need to think about this. Pretty sure Jonesy's just being out. We'll take... Kaylee Stress is an amazing life. Fuck this, we'll take her anyway, okay, so... You can go in the, like, third slot. So who do we want then? Could take Richard out, our new arbalist. You can go on the back. You've seen this back end formation before, and the reason is that it's really fucking good. Okay. Hellmaster in slot 2. And, tempted to go for our man at arms, go for Red Katana Fury, but I mean, there's no reason why I can't do a fucking. In fact, yeah, sod it, let's do it. Right. There's no reason why I can't do a level 1 dungeon with 3 level 0s, it's not that big a deal. Also, it means I don't have to buy upgrades and shit for them because they can't have them. So let's check out the skills that we've got going. Right, okay. That's fine, that's okay. Cry Havoc is a bit pointless if he's in slot 2, although it is very good. Lick Wounds, if he's... Oh, that's incredible. Yeah, okay, we need that. Blackjack, one of the best, like, stuns in the game. Most stuns, at least at level 1. Have like 100% base chance, 125%. So yeah, really good. Not insignificant on the damage either. So yeah, the target whistle's really good as well, because as well as marking the target, minus 20% protection's huge for things that are like, well, that have protection and are always a pain in the ass to take down. But I'm kind of still juggling money at the moment, so I'm not sure what we want. Crush is good, Rampart is good, Bellor not fussed about, Retribution. See, really, these two are the ones that I want, but I'm only going to buy one just to save a bit of cash. Retribution is too good to pass up though, so we're gonna buy that, and we'll work out what we're having later on. Snapshot must have. Suppressing fire isn't terrible. Do you think we've got three? No, we haven't. We've got the Arbalest and the Hellmaster benefiting from marked targets. The occultists can leave a mark. Baller, blind fire, battlefield bandage is really, really good. So I like having that. I'm gonna buy probably blind fire though, just because it's so good. It's so good. And who else have we got? We've got Kaylee, I believe. A couple of Lady Grey, yeah. So you should be sorted from last time. I've got both. That's the one with the mark. The question is, do I want that if I've already got the Arbalest that can do the same thing? I'm going to probably stick with that though, yeah. Right. So now I'm going to check that they've all got the right skills on. I know I can do this actually in the mission, but, you know, we'll do it now, save a bit of time. That's fine. Okay. So we want probably suppressing fire off and blind fire on. Yeah. Gary, what do you need? You want retribution on? What are we taking off? Bellor hits everything, which I never realised, and gives them minus dodge and speed. I'll probably leave that on over bolster. Yeah, it's pretty good. And our Houndmaster. What are we taking off of Blackjack? Cry Havoc, because you're in slot 2. Should probably have a look at any trinkets we've got as well. I can't remember what the trinket button is. There we go. Jester only, Crusader only. I feel someone should definitely have that, because that's amazing. Right, the health stone, that's obviously going to go on whoever's got the least HP, which I'm going to assume is, yeah, it is actually Andy. So, you, congratulations, you get a health stone. Kayla, you can have the Book of Intuition, because that's incredible for sacrificing one speed. He's probably most likely to suffer from stress. It's going to be one of the level zeros. So, I guess, yeah, okay, you can have it. I'm just thinking because, usually, like, the casters in the back also like targeting the back line. And I feel like you, if you're in the front, want one of these. And we don't have to put everything on, like, you know, why not? In fact, that'll probably do. I'm happy with that. Might as well shut that on someone. Okay, we're good to go. Didn't actually check how long this mission is. It's just short. So we've probably got time for two over the course of this episode. And I'm not entirely certain. Like, I know for a fact in the Weald you need, like, anti-venom. Cove, you need bandages. You need bandages in the ruins. Not 100% on the warren, so I might take a few of each. Two shovels is probably fine for a short mission. We'll just do my usual, take two of everything, 1k, one holy water. Food. I can't remember how much I usually take. Probably just one full stack, I think. See, this is what happens when you take time out. Twelve torches. Better to be on the safe side, I think. And I believe that's that. So we're ready to go.
They breed quickly down there in the dark. But perhaps we can slay them even faster.
Right, let's have a look at the layout. And we need to complete 100% of room battles. Let's head left first, because hopefully we'll get a scout and we'll be able to when we hit the next room.
A handsome reward.
And we'll be able to see what we're up against. Also, we do have a little battle coming up here. And like, worst possible thing really. If I could, I'd have given everyone a fucking disease deep stone, because it's good here. That hits everything. Doesn't do a lot of damage, but does bleed. Actually, this is why we put Blackjack on, so we're going to use it, because these swine slashes, even though they don't have like a lot of HP, they do a lot of damage. So probably we're gonna get our Retribution rocking. May as well hit this guy, take him down a bit more. So the way Retribution works is it marks us, which means enemies are supposedly more likely to attack that target. Doesn't often work out like that. Okay, yeah, I need to get rid of you in the back. Nice. Good shot.
Destroy them.
But it also means if our mount arms does get hit, he'll also like return fire, which could be a big source of damage over the course of a fight. I think we go for the slash here and try and take out. Well, unless we get a crit, it's not happening on any of them, is it? And that's no better, right? Okay, sacrificial stab it is. We'll try and take care of you. And now, actually, I'm pretty sure this guy's only got 3 HP. Okay. So if I do 2 and they get bled, then he'll die. Or I can just try and clear the control game and stun this guy. Yeah, I can hit you.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
He's racking up the kills like Bingham straight off the bat, and there you saw the Retribution active. And it stays active for a couple of turns, so we can now do other shit as well, like just go for the crush here. 4-7, so if it lands, he's dead. Nice.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
No one's really in need of healing, yeah. I guess I'll just go for the stab. And Andy for the finish.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. This expedition
we'll take all
at least promises success.
Still kind of like, later on, as you progress through the game. Oh shit, okay, yeah. Torches, let's not forget that. Yeah, later on as you progress through the game, emblems? Heirlooms become less of an issue, because you know you can only upgrade things so far, but you always need gold. So later on in the game you can just forego picking up heirlooms, but as it is at the minute, still very important to the economy of the hamlet for us. And we'll have a few more there. Okay, 3 fucking swine slashes is a pain in the fucking arse. So again, probably just going to try and control them wherever possible and let Bingham finish them off. Nice dodge. Probably just going to go for the stun. Does a lot of damage for a move that also stuns that. Right. 5 HP, 3-5. So we've got like a 30% chance of finishing them off. didn't quite get it. But you know. See, while I'm saying that, like, no one really needs healing yet, that's because, like, the occultist heals, like, just a big fuck off one thing, do you know what I mean? Like, it's kind of devalued healing someone for, like, 30 on when they only need, like, I don't know, 5 HP. But Battlefield Bandage could be good for keeping people topped up, but at the same time, I'm kind of relying on with impunity. Richard to do most of me damage here. 47 with the bleed, so chance to kill here. Yeah, especially if we crit, that'll do the job. From our lands. Like, now is probably a decent time for a heal on Andy. Took the bleed though, which isn't great. And just blind fire. Yeah, let's go for this. Motherfucker, he's dodging like fuck. Yeah, I wanted to try and get the stun up just to stop him doing any more damage in this, like, next turn. But if we can get the stab here, then it doesn't matter.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Let's have a quick look at our inventory. One damage, I might just leave that bleed. It's not too bad. Saying that, I am going to have to start making space, so I could just use up this food here. Probably unnecessary at this point, but you know. In fact, should have saved it for the Houndmaster to counter the bleed, but never mind. There's our first.
Such blockages
our
are
first
unsurprising.
Trouble usage.
These tunnels predate even the earliest settlers.
Pop another torch. Yeah, it's high enough. As long as it's radiant light, I'm happy for the time being. And they're really the problem, because even though vomit doesn't do, like, much damage, it's the diseases that you get from it, which are, like, so cost prohibitive in terms of, like, treating them, and long term it just sets you back so much. Like, you're not really at risk of losing anyone from it, but, like, later on, if you can't afford to pay for, like, whatever, stress relief, could be it. Right. I've also just realised that this does 15% more damage for your beasts, which is very good here. Let's try and hit you. Get rid of you. Again, just cause do not want. The diseases do not want. Okay, got bled as well. This isn't great so far. He's got 3 HP and the bleed, I believe, is just for 1. So I guess we'll go to work on the Swine Drummer as well. Actually, I should have finished that guy off. Although, no, Abyssal should be good here. Precision, we'll take that. Power. Really enjoying any small amount of, like, stress relief we can get, because I've just realised that I've got no way of dealing with this on this team. We could have if I'd taken Cry Havoc, but the position my Houndmaster's in, I wouldn't be able to use it. You should definitely finish him. And then we're looking at healing the Man-at-Arms next turn. Could probably go for a stun on you, actually. Just,
a devastating blow.
To keep the people from being bled. Why is he bleeding for 3 damage a turn? Okay, he's only got 1 more left in him. Set a retribution away. Say, like, I mean, I feel like it's a waste of a bandage when it's already went two rounds. That bleed, I might as well just leave it. What I might do, though, actually, is you're stunned. So I'm going to battlefield bandage you. Give him the healing... heal and receive buff. So when he gets healed off, a couple of Lady Grey now, it should be decent. No, maybe not. Theoretically, it should be decent. How much do you want to bleed the poor lad? Leave him alone. He does not deserve this. Well, we'll give him another one then. So he's at 40% extra heal and receive now. So assuming I don't get stunned here, which I did, then all would have been fucking well with the world. Right, we definitely need a bandage now. Again, it's only turn 3. So I think I can probably get away with a stun. And, like, cheese it for another turn or two and try and get a bit more... squeeze a bit more healing out. And what is quite nice is... fucking hell, that's adding up. Might even go for a lick wounds here. Just try and keep ourselves topped up as much as possible. Okay, no sense in going for anything else now. Might as well just lay the damage down. Right. Let's do this. Okay, maybe I don't need to do that. Like, if I kill... ah, fuck's sake, man. Land the stun. Come on. All I want to do is heal the man-at-arms. Right. Decently, please. That's what we're talking about. 15. Resist the bleed. Kayleigh, you can get stunned again now. That's fine. Right, let's finish him off. See, this is why we need space.
But a victory nonetheless.
Do you kind of want the portrait, but what do I drop for it? Is the question. I'm thinking maybe the antidotes. I know it was a complete waste buying them then, just for us to fucking leave them here, but you know. Need the heirlooms. Okay, so we can head back the way we've been. And what is pretty good, compared to what we started the dungeon with, people's stresses actually went down a little bit. Just because I worry, I'm going to give you a bit of food here. And we'll head down. We've got two battles coming up here. Bingham, why'd you do these things? That was lucky that we got the food there. That was so lucky. Okay, you're going to eat this food again. Kayleigh having a fucking pig out. See, normally you'd have to use the herbs there to guarantee that you'd get the food. And I just thought... that's it. We're getting out here, or Bingham's getting blighted. And I've just realised that he's out of order. What's happened there? Shit. This is what happens when you don't pay attention. Right. So what do I consider the bigger threat? Swine Slasher or the Drummer? Probably going to go on the Drummer. I mean, that can heal damage, I suppose. I don't really have the best methods of dealing with stress in this party. If I mark you and it actually lands, nice. I'm going to stun you. Like, literally, this shows how much that, like, how highly I value the killing the Swine Slasher over the Chopper, even though he's got only a fraction of the HP. And he can't bleed or anything, I don't think. Or maybe he can, I can't remember. Right, but this is what we were waiting for. Because this should do a fuckload of damage now that he's marked. Didn't even get a chance to do any stress dealing attacks, so we're pretty good there. And the bleed. Bingham, you can probably notch another kill here on the Spine Slasher.
Nice.
Consistent as fuck, that's what I like. Probably going to go for the mark again here, just to try and offset the fact that he's got a bit of protection. Didn't want to heal the Houndmaster, just in case he got bled again and it stacked up, which would be like a nightmare situation. If we land the stun though, which we never, would have bought ourselves a turn to heal. They're literally landing like all of their debuff attacks at the moment. I suppose I can still heal, because it's only the occultist and the Houndmaster needs it, and he can self heal. So yeah, that's good. And while he has stunned our Arbalest, he has also put our party back in the right order. And this should do a hell of a lot of damage actually, because it's got the bonus from being a beast and being marked. Landed the bleed too. I think we just go for the kill here, rather than trying to stall it out another turn. If he goes first, he'll die at the bleed. He's going to die at the bleed anyway, so I might as well do this. Get some heals off, small as they may be.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken.
Well, we're getting a shitload of food. Don't need the anti-venom, or at least we haven't so far. Pop torch and we'll be on our way. Should have popped a torch really. Okay, this isn't too bad, and we got the surprise, which is great. Yeah, I'm thinking that we stun the big guy. It's 75% chance on him and 100% on Brigand Cutthroat. In fact, you know what, let's just go for the guaranteed, like, stun. It's all damage reduction, really. And then we're going to do this.
Singular strike
to try and set up the kill. Oh, and we might just be down to the big guy here, which would be fantastic. Right, come on Bingham, don't let me down. You let me down. Okay, that's fantastic. That's a great result. That's fantastic. A lot of damage, but best target for us. Although point blank, I know he hit the guy in the front anyway. Now the question becomes, do I try and stun you? And I think the answer is yes. We can deal with one blanket fire, that's okay. We're going down this time. And probably set up the retribution here, since he's already stunned. Heal off on Gary there. Healed for zero, nice. If he'd been bled there, I'd have been so pissed off. Right, drop a mark here. And he's in the wrong fucking spot. So I'm gonna just use the turn to move him back. Like, the Houndmaster and the Arbalest are our, like, main sources of damage. So it sucks losing a turn on any one of them. I guess I just start fucking piling damage on you. Fuck me, look at that, 15 crit. Okay, gonna heal Gary for hopefully more than zero this turn. That's what we like. Get a bit of stress relief as well. Resistance bleed, perfect. Only one bleed out of that. No, sorry. Two bleeds out of that. So not the worst result. So this should actually do a fair bit of damage now. What do you like being bled, eh? Probably just go for the finish, to be honest, eh?
Prodigious size alone it doesn't... does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
No one needs healing enough to warrant stalling another turn. And again, we're getting so much fucking food. But that's all good, because it means we get a heal with it and still keep some for hunger activations. And I am going to drop something for 825 gold. Gold is what we need. Why can't I fucking take something for the gold? What's going on? What do I want to drop, if anything? Probably the other... I tell you what, I can just use the bandage on you. Then just take the gold. There we go. Zoom our map out of touch. So I don't think I need to... See, I can't tell. If we go right here, then basically there's definitely treasure in that room. There could be a room battle. And yeah, we'll do that first because then we're only backtracking one hallway. Well, that came out anyway.
Curious is the trap maker's art. His efficacy
instead of backtracking potentially two hallways if we do end up having to come here. Yeah, we'll have another torch.
Wealth
that's nice.
Beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Saying this is why it's good to have extra food. Again, probably should have popped the torch. I'm saying there was a battle here, so we have saved ourselves a bit of backtracking there. Resistance to disease, thank fuck. Okay. Definitely want to abyssal artillery these two. They're like the priority targets, the back two. Yeah, I think this is probably enough for a kill. 5 to 9. So even if we get 8 and land the blade, that's still enough. Never mind. And here's the things that cause blight after I've threw me fucking anti-venoms away. Oh, this is why I need to bring a plague doctor with us, pretty much. I can retribution the third spot, so I can do this and potentially get a kill here, which is the best possible result for that. As long as they don't keep getting blighted and it doesn't stack up, then that's fine. We are going to sniper shot you. Minimum damage. Sucks. You need to go next. Land the blade, come on. Right, okay, he's going down next turn. Every cunt's getting blighted. It's not fun. Gonna have to start doing some serious healing here. So who's in most need? I think I can't heal myself for that. Right, well, I guess I'll go on the man at arms then.
The slow death. Unforeseen.
I think Kaylee needs to heal herself, really. Not the best heal. Okay, now if we can land a stun, probably on you. It's just not going my way, this is it. Another blight? Yeah, of course. Right, fantastic. Just killed one of them, at least. Try that again, because you're still the person who needs the most healing. Gary's got a lot of HP, so he can deal with us. Try and land a stun here. Yeah, stun resist must be fucking crazy, because that's two in a row. It's two for two. Nice, beautiful. Yeah, let's do it. That's what I'm talking about. And for the finish.
Another one falls.
Didn't do too badly there.
Ghoulish horrors.
And I think that the jade gets left here. Because it's not worth a lot. Unless I'm prepared to throw away anything else. Need to start using the dog biscuits as well. I tell you what we do. We do this, we use our one torch.
The match is struck.
Then we take
a blazing star is born.
Okay, that's that. We are, however, gonna continue because there's still two rooms. I've still got both dog biscuits. And we're in pretty good shape, stress isn't too bad. And I need the money. So, yeah, we'll do it. Another hunger activation, so we've got enough food left for like one more.
Carelessness will find no clemency in this
now
place.
That's a two damage bleed. Which I wish I had a bandage for. Never mind. You'll just have to take it, Andy. Nice. Shit, really should have used the fucking... Actually, I'm worrying about going into a new room and having to fight in dim light, but we've already done all the room battles, so there's nothing to worry about in that regard. Bingham, stop it. Bloodthirsty, okay. Let's check that out. Okay, it's not a good quirk. Fascinated with injury, wounds and torture. Fantastic. Well done, Bingham. I wonder if the... motherfucker, could you stop getting
cruel
hit by traps?
Spring to life.
Look at this, look at the fucking stress. Jesus purpose. Christ.
The light, the promise of safety.
Totally didn't even need to pop them torches. If I was min-maxing, I could have left it, because we're leaving now anyway and got a bit of money back. That fucking stress though, getting hit by two traps. That's like 40 stress just piled on right there. Motherfucker.
Their squeals fade. Their confidence is shaken.
Still, managed it without any major incidents, so that's not too bad. And we do get that that healing charm, which is going to come in very useful. Not bad on the heirloom front either. And they've all hit level 1. Nymphomania. Okay. And Ruins Adventurer. Okay, they're all good.
Seditionists and heretics skulk in the alleys. They must be found out.
Threats to our collective safety are never in short supply, but this week our local constabulary received a welcome augmentation. Idlehound Masters Game 1 Resolve Level. That is fucking absolutely insane. I've only got one and I've just taken it. Like, basically, that's a free level. But I'm not sure whether that's like, if he's idle this week, next week he'll get it, or whether I've missed the boat. I think it's probably the latter, unfortunately. Which is a shame. But, you know, who can predict that? Let's check out our stagecoach. Yeah, not interested in either of these at the moment. We've only got one space left. I think Hellion's probably the place to spend that. Let's see who we've got with more stress. Hang on, just need to take these out. Oh, hang on. The Houndmaster's portrait has a... has like an outline around it. So maybe it's looking slightly more hopeful. I wonder if by idle law it means like just not on a mission or just not doing anything. Like if I put them in the tavern, am I going to miss out on that free level? Is it worth risking it? I suppose I could probably just leave them until next time, next week. In that case, Kaylee, you need some stress relief. You can drink your cares away. Could probably start investing into these as well. So I think that's probably it. Yeah, just to be on the safe side, and we'll get him some stress relief next week. You'll just have to have a shit week, mate. So, in terms of stress, we're pretty good, I think, for the rest of us. Yeah, fantastic. So I guess now then we... probably going to do another short mission just because we've already done one. And even though I'm streaming, I don't like just letting it go on for hours and hours and hours. So we've done the warrens, bugger the warrens is what I say now. Really, I should be looking at this. Rockwood Centre. Scouting whistle, 30% scouting chance if torches below 51%. Trap disarm's really nice, but me torch is never going to be that fucking low. Swordsman's Crest, we've already got one. Blood Charm, 30% bleed resist. Are we going back into the Warrens again for another fucking skirmish? I think we are. Right, let's sort our party then. So, it's a level 1, so I am going to try and take a level 0 with us. But I'm not sure who goes where. See, this is kind of the hard thing, setting up me party order without knowing whether they've got the skills that I want to use already, like, unlocked. Which, I think Amy's pretty much perfectly set up. So you can go, hang on, you can go in the third spot. We'll take Jonesy with us. Good strong healer in the backs. And do I want to take another level 0? This is the question. It would have to be the leper who I haven't given a name to for some strange reason. Could take me. Yeah, we'll put me in the front because I know I've got point blank, and then someone else who wants to be in the front, like the leper. That could work. Right, so let's back out then. And have a look in terms of what we need. So I'm pretty much sorted, aren't I? See, I could get Duelist Advance because it's like so fucking good, and take off Tracking Shot. Which I might do. Let's see if we've got anything more pressing than that. Because that's kind of just a quality of life thing. Liam's fine. Yeah, he's got the ideal skill set up. You've got Chop and Hugh. Revenge, Withstand, Solemnity, pretty much ideal, really. Especially if you're in the front spot. Could maybe get rid of Hugh in favour of something else. No, that's pretty good. I'm happy with that. And that's it, isn't it? Oh no. Yeah, that's it. Let's see if we can upgrade any kit. Yeah, I think I'd probably rather get this over Duelist's Advance, just for the time being. Probably should have bought that first. That seems to be.
Plan relies upon a strong arm.
You can just guarantee I'm going to buy things, then look at upgrading and go, oh yeah, I should have done that beforehand, really. Never mind. Okay, we're doing alright for gold, so I might pick up thingy. Let's see if I can make it any cheaper first. I can. That is probably more important, bro.
Some may fall, but their knowledge lives on.
Yeah, it's gonna be a while before I'll have the crest necessary to do that, I think. But yeah, in fact, definitely want point blank. Definitely. What are we using? Open vein's good. Not going to bother with tracking shot if we're taking it off. Pistol shot's always going to be there. Not going to bother with grape shot. Or am I? Just more accuracy and a better crit modifier. Sod it, we'll go in. We'll go heavy on it. Just don't think about it. Needs to be done anyway. So I'm definitely not buying Duelist's Advance this week. Because I'm trying to keep my money in decent order. Right, so we're ready to go. Just need a provision. And yeah, was the Warrens, wasn't it? Another short mission, so same again. Actually, I already had one shovel. I'm not going to buy an extra. Might live to regret that. 12 food was more than enough last time, although we did get extra. Didn't end up using the herbs or the key, but that doesn't mean that we won't. I had torches left as well, didn't I? I suppose torches are the least pressing of the issues, because they only cost 75 to begin with. It's all this shit that's where your money goes. I think this is a good idea though, and I'll actually hang on to my anti-venoms this time. Bring 1k, not going to bother with the herbs. Or am I? Yeah, you know what, we'll bring 2 herbs. Oh, I already had 1 herb, right. I should really pay attention to that. That'll do. That's good. Yeah, we're good. Not gonna bother with holy water.
They breed quickly down there in the dark. But perhaps we can slay them even faster.
So we've got a battle in our first hallway, straight off the bat. Two empty crates. Wow. Okay, here we go. Yeah, this isn't bad. We can deal with it. Right, point blank. Decent amount of damage. And we do want our leper in the front, because loads of HP, 10% protection. We can make use of that. Probably go for the Thrown Dagger. And finish him off.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Yeah. Also remember the Thrown Dagger does extra against marked targets, but I don't think I've got anybody that can apply a mark in this. Guess we just go for the chop on you.
Destroyed.
Okay, I'm not... I forgot a name yet, but we'll rectify that when we get out of here, because you've earned a name. Nobody really needs healing, so I feel safe doing this. That'll prevent that getting another attack off until we can deal with that.
Decimated.
Look at that, Amy with a crit.
Foolish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud.
Need to remember to put myself to the front of the party after every battle so I can get a point blank off. Let's have a quick check that one map. Yeah, I mean, we'll just go straight over. Sorry.
Mind that such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Spare torch. Might as well just use that right now. Okay, nothing. Nothing isn't bad. I mean, I would have liked a chest or something. But if you're gonna be forced to backtrack... Speak the devil, that's Amy nearly taking the door off its hinges, if you're wondering. Fuck now. Okay, I can't remember what I need to do for this.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
I can't remember. Do we burn it? I don't think we burn it. Okay, I guess we just read it then. I'll take it on the chin, whatever it is. Shit. Shouldn't have done that, never mind. Hopefully I can get rid of some of that stress in this battle here with some crits. No one still needs healing, so probably safe to get a stun off on you. You're the dangerous one.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
Probably go for the Thrown Dagger here as well. If you can just one-shot this carrying me, that would be great.
Be gone, fiend!
And of course, because I'm stressed now, they're all going to start attacking me. Probably just start working on you, I think. Leopard's damage is so high. Always, like, underestimated. Can only hit him in the back. 49, decent chance.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Bleed is pretty heavy, so we're gonna use a bandage. And then I guess we'll just go for the open vein and try and finish the job.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, good.
They in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Alright. You can charge us now if you want, don't mind. Right. Yeah, Westy.
Yeah.
West Highland Terrier.
Oh my god, Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Right, put me back in the front.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
We've learned not to piss about with them. The surprise is fantastic. Start with a point blank shot, hopefully get a decent amount of damage up on the big guy. I think that's actually max damage, 18. Look at that, that's incredible. Right? You're a grave robber, by the way. And you just killed that guy in one go, well done you. Might go for the stun, we'll lay him. Come on, big chop from Marshier. Right, we can take them all day. So far this fight's going exceptionally well.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Ah.
Probably a good time to start healing now. That's indicative of how well this particular run's been going, that I haven't actually had to heal yet, and we're like 2/3 done. But that's how it is in Darkest Dungeon, it's always feast or famine.
Their aim formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
We should still have Radiant Light when we come through here. And the Scout, so I think we only have to go right, but we're probably going to do both. Head left first. Well, the map is a bit irrelevant now. And I forgot to move me forward. Shit. Never mind. Still get a decent attack off. I might even, seeing as we've got the surprise here, I might go for the grip. Can lunge hit whoever's in the front. It's forward too, like, which is really bad. I didn't realise the blight was so strong for that. Yeah, why not? Nothing's really been living long enough to warrant using damage over time. Okay, big Hugh.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
That's okay. We can live with that. Throwing dagger should probably be enough. Yeah. Even if it wasn't, the blight would have taken care of it. One damage bleed. Probably safe to leave that. Yeah, going incredibly well so far. Making record
mount,
time.
So too will resistance.
Down to 3 food, so I hope we don't get another hunger activation, otherwise we're fucked. Okay. Yeah, you're in the wrong position, love. So, the Shadow Fade's actually really good here. Then, yeah, I'm going to get another. Didn't actually even get the stun, which is a shame. Right, big damage, come on. 14, pretty good. And the knockback, brilliant. You're gonna go for just the big chop and see if you can't like take him out.
Annihilated.
24 crit. Oh. Might even try and stun you. Well, I'm not gonna stun you with judgment, obviously. Again, no one's in like dire need of healing, really. Maybe after this that I might be. If I get bled, which I do. See, now's a decent time to use Blight Dart. This guy's got a lot of HP. And I don't think I can finish you here. If I get max damage and bleed, I can't, but... No. He's stunned anyway, so it doesn't really matter. If I use Hue, I can actually hit both of them here, which is pretty good.
A singular strike.
And with a crit. Hopefully I can let this go one more turn and get a heal off on me. Holy shit, you know what I've just realised? I was ranting and raving about that fucking healing trinket that I got on the last fucking mission that I haven't even
it. Cursed champion falls.
So bad.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
Okay, let's have a look at these. 3 damage for 2 rounds, that's going the distance. Got the bandages for it. Right. Did we bring a key? I can't remember. Yes, we did. And I recently found out that when it's an heirloom chest like that, you only get heirlooms if, or like, the percentage chance of getting heirlooms in it is like really low if you don't use a key, and obviously really high if you do. But that's good information. Because it means later on when I don't need heirlooms, then I know not to use a key on them. Am I actually heading the wrong way now? No, I'm heading back the right way, that's okay.
The way is lit, the path
right,
is clear.
Right, final room and then we're done here.
We require only the strength to follow it.
Okay, yeah, fuck the shambler. Right now, I'm not even trying that. Oh dear. Oh dear. See, this is why. I don't even know how I've used an extra food. Like, where that's come from. Sorry,
to fall
kids,
for
you're gonna
such
have to
a little thing. A bite of bread.
I suppose it's a bit late giving you all food now, but. Never mind. Okay, trap time. 90%. It's gonna be me. I'm not gonna use the stress relief. Yeah, why not? Read the books. Good or bad though. Misses the spot. Oh, that's so nasty. Oh. Oh, that's only 1% crit. There's one that's like an accuracy debuff which sounds similar if I recall. And that's like the worst thing ever on the lever because they're not very accurate anyway. Okay, I think we need to get to work on these. Because surprisingly enough, this is how it works. It's quickly turned to where we're not in an amazing spot for health or stress. So, got a decent heal there. Just need to make it through this fight and we're good. Probably gonna pistol shot you because the disease is the last thing I fucking want right now. That's okay, don't mind that. Dodges are good. No, the leper is the one person really who I don't need to heal, so I don't feel any problem in doing this. Guess we start work on you. If I'm going to do that, I might as well just use the throne dagger to us. And pistol shot to finish. 5-9. Not the best chance. Or do we just go for the open vein and the kill here? Which is what I think I'm going to do. Still need to just party heal, try and get us back up. That's fantastic, really. Max heal and a crit. Then you can attack him as much as you want, he can take. He can even self-heal, which I might. Just can't really hit anyone, can I? Yeah, we'll take the self-heal. Really need to deal with him, he's been alive far too long. Come on, another throne dagger. Okay, yeah, looks like it's another pistol shot. Finally goes down though. Again, we're just going to stick with party heal. The leper's bad accuracy comes to bite him in the arse. Light's decent here. So I know them do have a little bit of protection. If I can get a bleed going as well, that's fantastic. And we do. Nice. An extra 5 damage for free. So even though we've come out of this in like record time, like the last couple of rooms is where it's really gone to shit, hasn't it? In terms of stress, he's gonna die off his wounds anyway. Or actually, just have to open beer.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task.
And that's it. So we are just gonna head straight back to the hamlet.
Some experiments should have never happened.
Quite a lot of stress at the end there.
Work ending them.
I think we did alright on a money standpoint though. 7 grand's pretty decent. Absolutely shitloads of crests, which I do need.
Let the organ notes ring out from the abbey.
Right, okay.
The sisters are gathering.
So I could get an extra vestals, but we don't have room in our barracks at the moment, and I've already got 2, so I'm not in a rush for another one. Kaylee, you absolute loser. A couple of Lady Greys experiencing double vision after a long night of drinking. Well done. However, say that at the top there, our Houndmaster, after only 1 fucking mission out and 1 town event, is now level 2, so that's pretty decent. What I'll do now, because I'm going to end it here, I'm not going to do another mission, but I am going to put people in stress relief and what have you now, so I don't have to think about it next time round. And I'm going to name Marshears. Right, so Liam, you're a cleric, so you'll enjoy. No, that's me. You'll enjoy being put in the transept. You've got quite a lot of stress, Andy. So you're getting put in the brothel. Sorry, Kayleigh, by the way. Kayleigh being Andy's partner in real life. Here's an extra coin, I wasn't here. Right. Me, I'm gonna drink my cares away. And I might just leave. Even though Amy's got roughly the same amount of stress, she's probably not coming on the next mission, so she'll leave. She'll recover a bit just by being idle. And I think that's probably it. Let's check out Stagecoach. Do we have a bounty hunter yet either? I don't think we do. We don't. Could get a bounty hunter. Did want a Hellion, but we'll take a bounty hunter.
The thrill of
need a few. Oof, shit, we've only got one deed. We need another 15 for that. Right. Okay, well, I might just leave it there then. In terms of naming Marshes and our new bounty hunter, I'll do that at the start of the next episode, I think. But yeah, pretty successful. Not too bad. I haven't lost anyone yet. But, you know what they say, pride comes before a fall and all that. So it's only a matter of time before I get overconfident and lose someone. Still, it is what it is. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.